Hello, I believe I'm live right now, and I'm going to wait for your comments to say if I am alive or not. Somebody say hello so we can begin. And I know, there you go. Thank you, Sangeet, Happy, Amra, and one other who have said hello. And welcome, Payal Patel, Akshay, Himanshi, hey, what's happening? Vinay, what's happening, buddy? I hope you're not on a ride right now. Very good, because riding and talking is a very bad idea. Oh, well, riding and being, watching somebody live. Anyways, welcome, everybody. Hey, Ma, thanks for always like being there. Love you. Welcome, welcome. So, today is a really special live cast because I'm going to be introducing you to my best friend. I'm sure you guys already know who this person is, and it gives me like it's great joy when you can just have friends who come on and talk about what helped us in our lives to really, I won't say make it because I think we're still on our journey, and but we just have a lot of fun on the way, and I think that's exactly what we want to talk about. So I am going to wait for Neil to give me, yes, Neil Bhopalam, very good. He has given the invite. Neil, waiting for you to come on board so I can formally introduce you. Formally. Formally.
Man, this Instagram camera, no matter how much I try and rehearse it, I'm looking like a chomu right now. Wait, man. Itna
While you do that, let me just tell everybody something that
mehnat
nobody knows. Only the people who are close to Neil know this, that Neil, still to date, where everyone has transcended into a smartphone, still uses a phone back from the 19 back from our college days. It's
Yeah, this is
it
it.
does not have. Can
Like,
you see the phone? That's
hello.
the.
I can't find it right now. The AC remote's the closest.
Even the AC remote has more features than a Neil's phone.
That's true. That's
And
true.
that is incredible because I've come around full circle from going all smart data plan, high Wi-Fi speed to then watching The Social Dilemma on Netflix
Yeah.
and understanding how, that's it's not a healthy thing. And
No.
you've always been on point with that, and which is why I consider you as one of the wisest people I know.
Siddhant, you know very few people, my friend.
Humor has always been Neil's forte, and no man, to credit you, to be honest, right from college, we were all growing up and finding ourselves, and a lot of my vocabulary in terms of how I deliver humor to how I what I find humorous
Yeah.
is all thanks to you. Yeah, so I credit a lot of my humor comes from you, and everybody who finds my humor really bad, you know who the source is.
Me. No, yeah, this is too much. Of course, I get my wisdom and Tehra from you.
Good,
And the
we rehearsed
motorcycle,
that
so.
before.
Oh, crap. No, but Siru, thanks, yeah, brother from another mother. Thank you so much for hooking this up. And it's kind of nice because the previous sort of chats I've had have been with people who I know. Most of them have been because of some promotions or stuff. So I've not really had a chilled out chumma chat catch up wala Instagram chat ever. So this is the first one.
I will be gentle then.
Yes, please. Thank you.
Neil,
Haji.
where do I begin from? So, to get all of you all on board, and the reason I'm doing this is because as of 1st November, I will complete 16 years of being a professional actor. And although I consider, but although I consider the definition of being a professional actor is to get paid. When you get paid for the profession, that's when actually the
Yeah.
clock starts. But for us, it started a lot earlier, and that's exactly what I want to touch upon on this topic, how you and I, just by fooling around in college, kind of made
Yeah.
that our career and our business. And had we stopped those impulses which came, you know, and A, the infrastructure, BMM, Bachelors of Mass Media, National College, it really kind of gave us that infrastructure to A, be able to fool around, B, show that fooling around, and C, for us to understand that this fooling around is something that we want to invest the rest of our lives doing, and we can actually make a career out of it.
No, for sure. Like, I just want to quickly give a bit of a intro to the peeps who've tuned in. A, thanks for tuning in and sharing time with us. And B, National College was, I mean, Sid and I did BMM, that's Bachelor of Mass Media, and both of us majored in advertising. Radio was also picking up big time in India at that time, so we tried to dabble and do a bit of that. Theater had started, that's where it, you know, with Atul Kumar's rehearsals. Thanks to your Masi being a principal, obviously you got everything on your own credit. I think so, but yeah. It's all merit based.
Totally, totally.
So, but she had this really awesome foresight, Mrs. Anand, our principal at the time, and she told Atul Kumar, who's the director, and said that, listen, you can rehearse in our college for free, but the students who are interested in acting, you train them prior to your rehearsal. So, like a good 2-3 hours of practice, Mila. So it was a win-win situation for everyone. And then, you know, these many years later, Mr. Karnik and I are having a conversation live on Instagram about the Back to the Future stuff.
Back to the Future, yeah. I you know, through this chat, I want to encourage those who are still kind of formulating their career plans or who are on their career as well, that conventionally we know that, okay, you get education, you pick a career and you kind of work towards it. Yeah. And our teachers and sometimes even our parents, hi Priyanka, even our parents, you know, might, that fooling around stimuli comes from a very fundamental thing within us, right? It's that thing which is already talking, our voice, which is already talking, which we don't know it's our voice, so we're trying to find out what that is, or even if we should listen to it or not.
Right.
And because we did, and I posted a video of us doing that helmet thingy among so many other skits. Oh my God. How many skits did we play and sketches did we do back in college that kind of formulated what you and I do right now for a living? Yeah.
Yeah.
Had really, I believe if we'd not done all that Chomugiri, we wouldn't be chomus right now.
No, professional chomus at that. But yeah, see, also there are various things, and you and I keep chatting about this offline as well. There are various things that contribute into how you land up doing what you're doing. Obviously, the Kida is there for performance, and that want to sort of appreciate, you know, get some acceptance, gain some hearts and win some friends thanks to your humor and your buffoonery that one can do, you know. That's the biggest reward one can get when you're in college. And at the same time, college also gives you that thing of like, good evening, of like, you can do more, you can work as well. So you can go to college, you can either rehearse for a play, or you can go to college and you can go for auditions post that if you're interested in, you know, being an actor and a performer. And then the media picked up so much, right? Like when we were at the right space at the right time, because suddenly people were looking for actors and people were looking for anchors and various things. So then that's when we showed up feeling fairly confident, because we were already, you know, entertaining the classroom. And it's also very much like what Adam Sandler and I guess his buddies used to do. When you watch, there, it's not that he's a buddy of mine as yet, but when you watch their old work, it's just him and his friends getting together and entertaining the people around them.
Yeah. So I just want to give a cue in to everybody here who, you know, knows Neil as a professional actor, and all those of our friends who knows him as a really laid-back guy. He was quite an active guy, because he used to, like he said, do the college work and post that. I don't know if how many of you all knew that he was also a radio jockey for Radio Mirchi. And he would go into the studio, do his recordings, come back and then do project work. Yep. Or at least be present while the project work was being done for him.
I'm a sheep generally, but sometimes I can captain a few things. I'll be like, yeah, that's a good idea. Let's do that. No, that's not a good idea. So
how much would you credit your radio jockeying days to formulating what your theater, obviously we know is a direct connect. We'll come to that later.
Yeah.
But, you know, being a radio jockey and then being an actor, what
very
was that
so, yeah.
thing like?
Mm-hmm. That was pretty much the foundation, because people are only judging you on your voice, no?
Mm-hmm.
It's not even this chat has so much information, because you can see where the person stays, you know, you can gauge mm-hmm. many things. But apart from sort of when you're only focusing on your voice to sort of create an entire body or a person that people can see without seeing, I think that's a really, not that I had thought about it so much. Wow, those are a lot of hearts. Not that I thought about it so much, but it just sort of happens.
Mm.
Then it becomes easier when you can perform completely.
So it's like you said at that time, you never thought about it at that time. You just did it because it was fun work. It was, you know, something that it was also a little paid. At least the bus ticket and the train ticket was paid for. And then after that, we did theater in college.
Yes.
And although it was introduced to us and available to us, not many of us did it. It was just a handful of us who then later got hooked by theater. And it was really interesting, and I also want to touch upon this, is then you really got into theater. In fact, you still are in theater and will continue to always be a theater practitioner.
Yeah.
I kind of branched out and did my one play in theater and had my fill. I said, man, this is too much ROI, too much, you know, there's not much return of investment that I'm getting. And I branched out into television.
Yeah.
And although our paths were as actors, but they were very different in the journeys. And I thought that was incredible. Just this morning, I was thinking about what we should talk about. And that just kind of stood out, how we started off from the same base. Our foundations were the same, exactly the same. From the presentations, which gave us confidence, to public speaking, to going to St. Andrews and participating in Mr. Andrews.
Yeah, man. Shit. I forgot about that one.
From there to goofing around in the improv comedy mad routines, to rendezvous, all the college festivals that we used to be participating in. And then you went into theater, I went into television, you went into very serious films, offbeat films, and I was just commercially into television and riding my motorcycle. You know, and we kind of then, and we've never worked together. I mean, our paths have always since then, we've never, our paths haven't intertwined. We've not worked together ever.
Not as yet, no. No, we didn't witness the Andrews. I think Siddhant qualified. I got kicked out of one of the previous rounds.
No, let me tell you.
Rejection okay, I gotta has tell you. Made me a stronger person.
I don't think I've ever told you this, Neil. I think I might have, but it was a very... I played a bit of a thing on you. So on that Mr. Andrews performance stage, I don't even think I won Mr. Andrews, but it came like first place or second. Second place was third.
Yeah.
And Imam Siddiqui, do you remember Imam Siddiqui? He was a judge. And he came and he said, you know, you should get into modeling and you should get the portfolio done. And I didn't want to do it alone. Like the entire process, I thought it will be. So I came and told you that, hey man, Imam said that you and I should both get into modeling and shoot a portfolio.
But that prank put me on the professional path, so thank you.
I take full credit for you being an actor today, man.
Thanks, man.
Do you remember our first portfolio? Do you remember the first portfolio we shot?
Yeah. Juhu.
We didn't have any money, so we went to a normal photo studio. which a guy who clicked passport size photographs, and he charged us 70 rupees per portfolio photograph, and
75,
it
I
was
believe, but yeah.
it 75. I got a discount,
Yeah.
man.
What a
And I remember even while we were doing it, we felt this was so cheesy because I
guy.
remember he took us to this maidan right outside his shop and he gave us some Paplu's hero cycle and he put this his seven-year-old school bag on you and a cap and asked you to pose like all, and I was laughing
Yo.
my ass. Absolutely, man. And you were, but you were con like you were in it. You were not inhibited. You were not like outside of it. What am I doing? You were totally in it.
Because I'm used to making a fool of myself, Sid. man, it's good.
Man, it's that fooling around again that's got us here, and I appreciate that.
But how did, once you branched off, once you were doing a lot of television, right? Like, how many shows, if you can sort of remember, how many television shows have you been a part of?
Man, that's a
Like
good
lugbug,
question.
yeah, just ballpark fit, like
I
a dozen
lugbug
at
about,
least.
yeah, like a dozen. I think a
Dozen at
dozen.
least,
Not
no?
too many, because I used to, I had a very clear funda. I used to do TV until I got a lot of money, and then I used to go on a motorcycle ride. And when money used to get over and I used to come back, then I had little money left, I would do some theater. I just keep coming back to theater. I was not in it, but it just happened. And then when money was completely run out, then I'll again take up a TV project. So, and it's that cycle. And if a film came in the way which it did once in a while, that was the, a perk, Sone Pe Suhaga. But
Insane.
I think for me, I realized that I've not been ambitious in my career, but I've been ambitious for life.
Well said. Okay, cool. Yeah, I get
And
it.
yeah, that's why I'm always on my rides whenever I can, which just means that I'm not that invested in my career. I would love to be a lot more, and I'm learning that about myself that I need to be. But it's good to just understand for myself, because then I'm not putting that pressure on myself anymore. I'm not like, man, I got to be a star and I got to put in these days and go to these parties and network and all. And I'm not, no, I'm just, yeah, enjoy life, like
You
Payal is
enjoy
saying. It
life,
just,
yes, of
yeah,
course.
literally,
But
that simply.
it's true. About 10 days ago when we were chatting on how, like, we don't have that. It's not that Shah Rukh Khan telling himself that, hey man, I want to rule Bombay and I want to have this really big bungalow in Bombay. Or no doubt one aspires for a better lifestyle and sort of grow each year. But it really is supply and demand also. If the evolution of the media did not happen, if multiplexes didn't open up, I mean, the more TV also became more because more people in India were buying television sets, from 30 years ago, 20, 30 years ago. Then now, hello, Nandini Srikant, that's famous casting director.
My hair is looking a bit.
Let's be
Let's just
talk.
go. Now
Maybe
you're
we'll get a
looking
part
good.
in some show
Little
where
hair,
she stars.
bassier voice as well. Yes.
I want to be actor. Yes. Stop giving me work at home, Nandini.
Welcome,
Oh crap!
Nandini.
Stop
Nandini, can
telling
you
me what to
move?
do. Oh shit.
Hit the mark, Neil. Stay on the mark.
Oh, not fitting the part. Come back tomorrow. Hit the mark. Yeah. Oof. So yeah, but it really has been good, and I think I'm looking presentable yet. I think it's a pretty awesome journey. I'm really amazed to see what's going to happen again, like next 10, 15 years. What are the kind of like things that we're going to be able to be part of, So that's far to go.
I think mediums aside, because we have no control on that,
No.
right? We
Correct.
have absolutely no control on the kind of mediums and how that's going to involve. Yesterday, TV was very big. Today, web series is huge. Tomorrow, podcasts will be the next big thing. We have no control, but we as, I think, artists and actors have that control within us to constantly be doing something, constantly being fooling around. Right? I think that's the essence of it. Just keep playing, just keep fooling around, and not get too serious about things, because you might just find your voice. In fact, I think there are better chances of you finding your voice as an artist by fooling around than putting that pressure on yourself and saying, "Ki nahi, main actor hoon and I'm only doing this kind of acting, and that's it. I can't be a voiceover artist, or I can't do
Also,
catalogs for shirts."
honestly, it's also what is available to us. Like, since you were talking about stage and stuff, and some time ago I wanted to go train to be a clown. I wanted to train as a mime artist. I had seen, once I got a taste of theater, I was like, wow, wouldn't it be awesome to like do a show where every night you're on stage and then maybe some days you have two shows. But that is not there. That infrastructure is only not there in our country and our surroundings. So what is there is vast amounts of television, TVCs, movies, and now, like you said, web series. That's as good as it gets. And usme se also there is only, something which would be A grade or, in each department.
So I'm going to link this because Sanjeev just asked a very interesting topic. Tell us about nepotism, right? And we spoke about the different mediums that we got to be doing, and I think the connect to that, and I remember reading in an article of yours recently, you had a very interesting different take on nepotism. Would you want to elaborate on that?
I don't understand what's the whole hoo-ha about people saying, "Arey," it happens all the time, every industry, of course. And I think it's everyone's, when a person sets up their business, their vision statement and mission statement and policies, they are free to set it however they choose to set up an enterprise, And if they take 80% of their own people and 20% outsiders, then yay. And also, as we have experienced, this is, I always believe, the media and sports and the arts are sort of industries where once you're really, really goes out into it, like a good 15 years into it, it can take you way further from the socio-economic space that you originally come from. You can really build a sort of life, which I feel most of the corporate structures, like a majority of it, have a certain, after this, after 2 years, there's that. Like, lottery lag sakti hai apni line mein. It can happen. That's actually Nandini's line. So it can happen.
I completely agree. I mean, this nepotism, because our industry just gets so much attention because that's the nature of it. Yet we won't point fingers to an industrialist who makes his son the heir, as opposed to the many CEOs who got far more experience, education to run his business better. An industrialist will always choose his son or daughter as the heir, you know. And when in our industry that has been done, then it's looked at as nepotism. And this is coming from two guys who are out from the industry, you know. And it's like you said, your son Fateh, in case he ever wants to get into the film industry, Nandini and you will help and do whatever you can, use all your contacts to help him. And I think that's fair. It happens in every industry, you know. Even for example, the army, which dad was in. I remember my dad used to keep telling me that if you joined the army, you would have been a great officer and I would have been able to help you, you know. And it happens even in that rigid structure of the army. Through whatever connect and contact, you can be posted in a more favorable place. That is not looked down upon. But if our industry, the film industry, does nepotism, then it's wrongdoing. You
Also,
know,
you're
I
fortunate
think it's.
because Uncle Mahesh Karnik was extremely popular and one of the cool cats on the scene. So yeah, so you'd be
Cool
like, they'll be
cats.
like, "Please come, come, Siddhant Karnik, aiye, aiye." Yeah, just become general to begin with. Yeah, here your staff.
Okay, I'm going to
So yeah,
switch to some questions now that the fans have written in.
yo.
The first question is from Sai Stuti, and she says, "How are you all keeping yourselves motivated and spirits high as it's a very difficult time for everyone. What a great question that is.
Yeah, I know, but while you were reading that, Upasana Shukla has said, how do you deal with rejection? Sorry, I just want to quickly interrupt and say that Upasana, I sort of just locked myself in the bathroom and like slit my wrists, dude, for a little while. After I bleed about 500 ml, I feel much better. So that's how I deal with rejection. Sorry, Sidhu, what was the question?
A little more constructive use of rejection, sorry, you know, way of rejection is the way I deal with rejection is something my dad always told me. And he says, you always do your best at an audition. It's the people who are on the other end selecting who screw it up. And they thought that was a great, they know nothing, especially the casting directors.
Difficult sometimes. Sorry, moving on. Bro, what was the question you had asked?
The question by Sai Stuti is, during these difficult times, how do we keep ourselves motivated and in high spirits?
You go for rides, no?
I go for rides. That's my fix.
Yeah.
Yeah. What's your fix?
I mean, I just go, you know, one day, not even one day at a time, one moment at a time. I sort of now plan everything like 3-4 hours ke caps, man. Like, so, okay. Before going to bed, I know roughly what I want to do till noon. And then in the morning, before I get to noon, I want to know what I'm going to do till like 4 or 5 o'clock. And then I'll sort of plan it again. I was totally, to sum it up, I was totally cool initially when lockdown happened. I was like telling everybody, hey, welcome to my world. This is like an artist's life. You and I also chatted about it. We're sitting there for 3 months doing nothing. But then about maybe last 15 days ago, last month, it started really getting to me because I'm not feeling productive. There's no plays, there's no shooting, you know, tidbits of this and that is there. And, but yeah, it's not too bad. As long as people, you're living for your family, I think it's fine.
Yeah, I just, I also want to add that, A, we're all in the same boat. Right, everyone has fallen, is feeling demotivated, is depressed to a certain extent. So take comfort in the fact that we are all down in the dumps. And that's just the way the world is trending at this moment. But to keep ourselves motivated, this morning I was watching a Instagram live with Gary Vee and Matthew McConaughey. I can't ever get his name right. But anyways, he's written this book called Green Light. And it's a very interesting perspective on when you're at a signal and the green light is on, that's the best time, right? Because signals go, you're going, you're moving, you know, it's everybody else is moving across with you.
Right.
It's a good space to be in.
Right.
But what happens when the signal's red, you know, when you have to stop or when the signal's yellow and you've got to slow down,
right?
Understanding the fact that there is a need for that to happen as well, and acceptance of that phase in that sense right now in the lockdown, and acceptance of the phase that you got to slow down or stop, take check of what you're doing, and an acceptance of knowing that it is going to turn green again, right?
Yeah.
It is going to go back, the world is going to go back to, I won't say being normal, but the new normal. There is some form of normality which is going to come in. In fact, at that time, when everybody starts, right, I feel, this is my take on it, I got to equip myself in using a motorcycle metaphor. I got to make sure that I got the best fuel in my bike, which means that I got to have honed in my skill set with all the time that I had, right, so that when the green light goes, I can literally throttle down and I'll probably be the fastest one to take off.
Yeah.
And I kind of keep myself motivated with that, with learning new skill sets to make sure that when the world comes back to its new normal, at least I'll have I have that much further to go as opposed to where I was. That's
sense.
Where I'm coming from, you know? All right, moving to the next question, unless you want to add something else to it.
Nothing coming to mind right now.
Okay. All right, Neil. Kinshuk Chavda asks, if you were not an actor, which other career would you choose?
An astronaut clown? Playing a violin? Yeah.
Ooh. Yeah. A clown in an astronaut outfit.
How do you tuck it over there? You can't tuck it with the globe, you
How do you hear it with the
know.
helmet on? How do you hear sound? How do you hear your violin in
It'll
space?
have to go to a little Jio Vodafone ka satellite, then go back to ISRO, and then it'll have to come into your suit.
Without the
I've thought
lag
this
in. All
through.
right. You clearly have. Thank God you never became an astronaut. For me, I would have become an army officer, for sure.
Yeah, 100%.
Okay, what were the challenges that you faced while you started in your journey as an actor, Neil?
Yeah, nobody really gives a shit about you initially. I think in order to gain some respect, it takes some time. In fact, I was chatting with my dad about this yesterday, that it's I also have a theory where a lot of people who come from very prominent, perhaps business families and industrialist families, their kids don't hardly venture into becoming actors or the arts in that manner, so and at the same time, and I feel people who have had somewhat of a nomadic life, also who are born and raised over here and over there, like a defense background or something, they're easier going with people and meeting new people, because in this field, especially initially, you're meeting so many people that you're meeting for the first time, and you're trying to be on a good, trying to put your best foot forward. You have no idea what it is. You're trying to be comfortable. So I think it's not hard. It's not the same, but you have to sort of work and stay consistent, and also not be bothered about that until somebody gives you some sort of bow, and they're like, "Oh, would you like a glass of water?"
Man, I really struggled. I remember when I was going for auditions, and I used to go for hundreds of auditions, and I'd actually counted, I would do about over 104 until I got one project. And literally those were the odds. And I used to then convince myself, okay, I need to do at least 100 auditions before I get a part. Those are literally the numbers that you were playing. And as I did more of it, the numbers kept reducing. But the thing is, now I know that. At that time, the frustration was so much. So many times I re-questioned my choice of being an actor, re-questioned if I had it in me to be an actor. And which is also very important, because you got to keep sort of do a self-check. Maybe you're not cut out to be an actor. Maybe you got to be truthful to yourself. Like I remember, I did this acting course, Kishore Namit
Yes,
Kapoor.
I remember.
Manan. And there were 50 people, out of which I'm the only one now who's still in acting in that batch, right? And the other 49 went off their different paths and ways. And that's not wrong. It's just that they re-question their own beliefs, whether they want to really do this or whether they have the perseverance to kind of put their everything into this. So I think even that journey is very important to have do those 100 auditions, because now after that I am so much smarter about how to go about with just an audition. The audition hasn't stopped. That process still continues. It's just that with something that you keep doing, you get better at it. So acceptance that the challenges will be there at the start for anything you do, and knowing that it's going to be like that is just the best way forward, I feel. Patience and perseverance.
Would you recommend people would train formally? All right.
And I know we've had these chats a lot. We've gone our separate, like you jumped into work and learning off as you work. And I felt that for me it was the process of classes and learning and being taught and teaching. It's because I honestly, I never thought I had it in me. I never thought I was a natural actor. And for me, the journey was to understand that it's better for me to learn the craft, literally down to the technical detail, than be a natural, because in the long run of things, a natural would only be in that comfort zone. right?
Yeah,
They
most
could
of
just
them,
have
yeah.
the first push they get is great because wow, natural actor. So boom, right there. But when they kind of plateau, a person who's learnt it, understood the techniques, will have a slower, but I feel a surer growth in the career of the arts or anything.
That's what my buddy
So
Will
that's
Smith says, yeah.
we talk often. I told him
Yeah,
about this.
he's stopped responding to my messages. How many times I have to subscribe to his YouTube channel? And yeah, but he's also had said in some an interview, no, that he works really hard, and that makes sense. That sort of training and skill, which later you sort of understand it. Pehle it's just like,
Understand
अरे
that.
करने हैं कीड़ा है चलो. Later you're like, thanks you.
True, true.
What's next, Doc?
Who supported you when you decided you want to be an actor?
My parents, they supported me. They had seen my this thing, especially, I mean, they were very happy with me doing so much theater work. Once my dad was like, is this what you really want to do as a this thing, or do you want to do like a post grad something? I'm like, daddy, bheja nahi hai. I can't study so much. Now I can study, but back then I couldn't. So I was like this thing, and then one of my at the end of one movie, like I was 21, one that I was doing, and they had changed the ending without giving me the brief. So by the time I had to perform that scene, my character was redundant. I mean, they technically they changed it, right? And they didn't brief me, and like janbujh ke they didn't brief me. I cried in my vanity van. I was just like this thing, and my parents then told me, listen, don't worry, you know, if this movie stuff is not, you just do theater, we'll support you. And I thought that was
Wow.
fantastic.
Wow.
And you?
Parents.
Same.
Definitely parents, yeah. My dad and my mom, they both believed out. My mom wanted me to be an actor, nautanki, and my dad wanted me to join the army, but great on his part that he said, I'll support you in anything you did. And you know, more even more than the financial support, which thankfully I never needed, it was their emotional support which was of
Oh
so
yeah.
much help. You
Yeah,
know,
yeah.
those 100 auditions where I got rejected from, I used to always come back, and it was mom used to make the best meal, and dad used to make his drink, give me a pat on the back, and he said, tomorrow's a new day.
There we
And that
are.
was beautiful, yeah.
Yeah. Anyone who didn't
Beautiful.
support you, as a
That's
Malayali
a good
asking.
question. Yes, I've forgotten those people who didn't
Ah,
support me,
kya
to
baat
be
hai, sahi
honest.
hai, super
I know
duper.
that they existed, but I've just completely forgotten about them.
Sweet.
You? Anyone didn't support you?
Those people who changed the scene. I'll show them
Hey, I wanted
revenge
to.
works as the best muse. Yeah.
Your Mahesh, your brother Mahesh,
Yeah.
right? Always told you have a plan B. Yeah, and you had a very interesting take on that because we as actors or anybody going into the freelance industry are always told you should have a plan B. But you have a very interesting take on that. What's that?
It, but it's also before I answer that, it's like it I feel especially people who are close to you give you caution, right? They like they love you so much, so, and sometimes they say, I don't think you should do that, or perhaps you should consider this thing. It's because they don't want to see you fail, you know. So the advice, I understand where it's coming from, and it's also, in fact, Mahesh was the one who used to do a lot of, like, he used to do a few MTV shoots, and he was in one movie which Salman Khan was in with the oh Jaane Jaana, what's the name of that movie? It's Pyar Tune Kya Kiya. Was it Pyar Tune Kya Kiya? I think so.
I don't remember the movie, but I think all of us know the song.
Yo, so he was
Ah,
basically
so
doing a few,
was he one
like,
of
in
the
the
topless
crowd.
dancers in the back?
Perhaps.
Was he one of
Yeah. He was definitely running the race somewhere where Bhai is like, listen, don't run too fast, okay? I have to win. So he'd come home and he'd tell us all these stories, and then I saw him on National College stage. They were doing Rama in 2000, and he was playing Hanuman, and it was, you know, the crowd loved the show, and I was like, wow, man, look at what he's doing. He's making the crowd like really love him, and they're like, totally involved. I want to do that. So yeah, but then if you have a plan B, then you don't give a plan A 100%.
So you're saying don't have a plan B?
It doesn't work for me. Maybe it works for other people, but not for me.
Okay. This is a very good question by Anu. She says, if you and Neil are cast together, what roles would you both like to play?
I'd like to do that entire Dumb and Dumber sort of Jim Carrey stuff.
Shri Shri Jim Carrey.
You know, we got to do that comedy because, like, Thriller villa to bas bahut ho gaya. Like, everybody's doing Thriller.
I'll tell you what. Instead of us, it's a question of supply and demand. So, you guys demand what you want to see of us and write it in the comments in the previous where him and I are back in college, we're fooling around. Write down in the comments over there what you'd like us to do and maybe we might just do it. I mean,
skits.
Why not?
Yeah.
Anna?
Anyway,
why not?
We were planning one little comedy show.
We should.
Like Little Britain and stuff.
7S Special, Sri. She asks, as an actor, how do you manage to snap in and out of the character?
Now, how to answer that?
Okay, I'll go first.
You go.
I don't really get so much into the character that I lose myself. It's that thing of, it's a misconception that when you get drunk, right, the next morning you can't remember anything. That's not true. You do remember everything. You just not want to admit all the things that you did do.
Yeah,
in the
yeah,
same
yeah.
manner, when I play a character, I never get so lost into it that I can't find my way back out.
Right.
So at the end of the day, when the makeup's coming off, you know, it's the character's also coming off. I don't have the trouble of switching in, switching out.
No, I'm and for me, sorry, you finished?
Yeah, I'm done. It's a wrap for me. Hello?
Sorry, network went choppy.
Huh.
We're back on. So for me, for theater, of course, then there's that much warm-up space that you get to get into character. And once you're on stage for like the next 2 hours, you're in the zone. For camera work, you got to keep, it's like playing hopscotch. Because you're jumping in and you're jumping out. You're jumping in, jumping out. Because to stay in character for camera work is extremely exhausting, I would imagine.
Yeah.
So, yeah. But, yeah. You do what you need to do, I guess, to answer the question.
So I think we've come to the end of the Q&A. we've gone on for a good 42 minutes. This is fantastic. And any questions over here? Hi, Betsy. Hello.
Betsy.
Any questions over here that you guys just ask us now and we will be happy to answer them. Meanwhile, as the questions come in, thank you, Neil. This has been wonderful in my 16 years of career. It started off with you and... Hey, listen, before that, you got to tell us how it started off. The call that we got. Like, I think
remix,
you have the chance because that's going to lead into the next remix call. Okay, okay. Can I tell the story or do you want to go tell this? That's the one because that just leads into the next live session. So this is something that you guys... how I got my first TV show, which was Remix... was Neil and I were sitting around in his house doing nothing.
In doing nothing.
And absolutely nothing, but we had the Kira to do something. And Neil was doing radio at that time. He'd done two plays and he got a call to give an audition for a TV serial. And both of us at that time with our egos looked down upon television. And he said, no, you know, I'm not interested sort of a thing. And he put the phone down. And I told him, hey, man, let's still go and make fun of the others that we're not doing anything. So let's just go and make fun of the others who are actually auditioning. And so we called back and they gave us the address. And I don't know where, where did we go? Parel or something, no?
No, it was really far. It was Goregaon. No, beyond. Film is
beyond. Anyway, it's really far off. We went on the bike. And Neil went and auditioned and came back out, and I was there just giving him company. And the casting director said, listen, why don't you audition? And I never really did. No, I, in fact, at that time, I was wanting to become a VJ for Channel
yeah.
V.
Yeah.
And they told me that your content is good, but you're very conscious in front of the camera, so you need to right. lose that. So I said, you know, this could, let's just do it. So I gave the audition, and I got a call. It's literally like, main apne dost ke saath gaya tha, usko interest nahi tha, mujhe bola aur maine kiya, and I got the role. It was yeah. literally that cliche, but that was the start. And that led into my first TV show, which is Remix. And yeah. I am announcing it over here for the first time that Karan Vahi and myself are going to go live on the 1st, commemorating our 16 years as professional actors over here. So tune in, and it's going to be Karan next. And I just want to link my entire journey of 16 years with every TV show that I did. So Karan with Remix, then Mahi Way with Pushti, then Pyar Ki Kahani with Wabiz, and Ek Tha Raja Ek Thi Rani Drashti, and then again we'll see where we go with there.
But and then put me back on the list also again, so then we'll chat.
You're going to be watching everything, no? Asking all the
obviously,
questions.
Obviously, obviously. Yeah. I'll be that guy who sends extra hearts and asks the same question over and over again. And then I'll insult you also a couple of times just so that I get your attention. And then you'll be like, yes, Neil has said this. So done. Then
anything
we'll
you
want to
share?
Conversation. No, we'll have to yeah. pick up conversation. Huh? Well, like maybe, what, next month we chat again? Obviously, I'll be seeing you
yeah.
that. But yeah.
So I'm going to, after every, I think after Ek Tha Raja Ek Thi Rani with Drashti, I'm going to do huh? one solo one. Where I do one interaction and kind of just recap the entire thing. So maybe if you could come on board and be a moderator and ask me how that yeah. journey has been, because I want to encapsulate 16 years as a career into that 1 month of live sessions and yeah. what I learned about myself, not just as an actor, but as a human being and how I evolved or didn't evolve.
Wow. Yeah, that's a lot, dude. That's very good.
I'm really pumped, man.
Very good, very good, very good. Sahi hai. To chalo.
Sweet.
Mil
All right, man.
Huh?
Yes.
Thanks, a lot
thanks Neil, for coming on board.
Lots of love. Love to the family. My dad's also saying hi. Folks are saying hi.
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 Hello.
Do
you want to say hi to them? Just swing the camera, no? Just say hi. I want to see them. Have they got their makeup on? Okay.
It's a very lounge state of posture.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. He's sitting in his favorite chair, no? That chair is super comfy, man.
For sure. Alrighty.
All right, man.
Peace.
Take care, buddy. Love you, man.
Bye, 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 bye.
Ciao, bye.
Ciao, ciao.
All right. That was that. I hope you guys, I'm sure you guys liked it because I enjoyed myself, and I'm sure if I enjoyed myself, you enjoyed yourselves, because that's one of the rules of acting. If you enjoy your performance, then you can be sure that the audience will like your performance as well. Not that this was a performance, this was just Neil and I chilling and talking about what worked for us and what did not. And we wanted to kind of share our journeys and what helped us, so that if it would help you in any way, that would be really awesome. Because Instagram is that medium which would allow us to talk about anything and be more intimate. And you know, another thing which I really like about this medium is, unlike in a TV interview or a publication or a print media, we as actors are always trying to put our best foot and our best face forward. We're hardly ever real. We're just kind of trying to say the right things to make ourselves sound better so we can increase our careers. But in an Instagram live, it's just us talking about ourselves and trying to, you know, give you all insights on our lives, and hopefully it could add some value to you. So with that, I will see you all on the 1st. When I get Karan and myself, Karan Vahi, yes, the big cutie, Sisodia, the star, Karan Vahi comes on board, and we will do a live chat and we will talk about Remix, those days, how we came about it, and where we are today, and how Remix was like the foundation for us. That was our school. It was about a school, but it was actually our school in acting. See you guys soon, and boom.